Get ready to match the stars from Lou Grant, Robert Walden, Brett Summers, from Vegas, Mark Braverman, Bonnie Stevens, Bill Daly, and Marcia Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rivers.
Hello, John. Thank you, friends. Thank you for joining us here on the Match Game. Hello, stars.
Hello, Jay. Hello.
Everybody ready?
Ready.
Special
it's
welcome to those who haven't been
here
in a long time.
It's cold enough here to freeze the blanks off a turkey,
Are you cold? Really cold?
It is.
Sure.
It is a bit chilly up here, I must say.
Yeah, but...
Robert Walden is having hot flashes, but that's his age. But Mark and I are freezing to death, aren't we,
sweetie?
We certainly are.
Whose jacket is that?
Robert Walden, the perfect person,
nice.
A gentleman of the old school and a fine human being.
Yeah, that's mine. Robert's I wouldn't jacket. Give it to you.
Is that Robert's jacket?
Yes.
This is Robert's dress.
This is Robert's dress. He only wears that on certain occasions.
You promised you wouldn't say anything about that.
You rascal. Would you say hello to Linda Nishihara and Mary Bingham? Hello, ladies. Welcome. Now you're here to play two games. And we're here to find out who you are and where you're from and just to get friendly with you a little bit. Mary?
I'm from Los Alamos, New Mexico. I'm married. We have 8 children and 2 twin granddaughters, Natalie and Elizabeth.
All right, Mary, welcome to you and good luck. Linda.
Hi, Jane.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm very well. Linda means pretty in Spanish, doesn't it?
Linda.
Que linda. Que linda niña. Are you married?
Yes.
Well, then you're not a niña anymore, are you?
I'm from beautiful Morgan Hill, California, and I live there with Eddie.
With who?
Eddie and Danielle, which is my husband and daughter. And I'm originally from Texas. Hi, Mom.
And, she here in the studio?
No, that's why I'm waving.
Oh, well, Texas. If she's not here in the studio, you see, wave to the camera.
Where's the camera?
Right there. That's it. Now you got it.
Is that it?
That's it. That's the camera right there. That's what that is, Bill. You've been wondering what
There's
that was.
There's four of those out there.
All right. Anything else you want to say?
No,
ready?
I just am here to play the game and hope.
Oh, you're here to play the game. I was wondering what you were doing here, Linda. All right. Mary, A or B?
B.
Oh, you're so good.
B's always been such a funny letter.
Yes. Oh, wonderful. I tell funny. You. Bad Benny is really bad.
Oh,
Benny. You're okay.
What a snappy
good
group.
Bunch. Lively, aren't they? Don't let it go to your head, Sal. Really bad. When he was a Boy Scout, he got a merit badge in blank. That's how bad he is.
I'm finished. You notice how much more quickly the game goes now that what's his name is no longer with
now,
us. What was his name?
I feel a certain obligation to uphold the tradition of this seat. Charles Nelson Reilly does a fine job here, and I'm just going to do my best to... Hold
all
the
right.
fort.
All right, the first thing you do is take your socks off.
Yeah. Well, I don't care that much.
Wrinkle your shirt.
Get your teeth capped.
And a good
then take your, you tip
I'll
your hair.
Yes, I can.
Ready. Mary Bingham, you're all ready. Bad Benny is really bad. When he was a Boy Scout, he got a merit badge in...
Mugging.
Mugging. There's a good answer. Merit badge and mugging. That sounds good to me. What came to your mind, Robert?
So I'm starting to get scared. You're not from New York, from New Mexico. I said mugging.
Aha! Uh-huh. Mugging. Had Arsene and crashed it out. All right, one for her. Yes?
Well, I figured that well, Boy Scout's a little young for mugging. I said stealing hubcaps.
Stealing hubcaps. Merit badge and stealing hubcaps. That's got two good answers so far.
I figure Boy Scouts are industrious, and I said rape.
Rape.
You got to work hard to get that merit badge, boy, I tell you.
Yeah. If you're a member of the Scouting Council
Don't write
in
letters.
Princeton, New Jersey, which is, I believe, the national headquarters, send your letters directly to Bart Braverman, Las Vegas, Nevada.
County jail.
Zip code. All right, Connie.
You like to burn up the forest.
Making fires. Yes.
I got another starting forest fires. That's two
starting
booze for
forest
us.
Fires.
Jump in with your food.
Yeah.
Okay.
Feel better now? Yeah. Yes, ma'am?
Do you realize this man is still walking free?
It's astonishing, isn't it?
Should have gotten the net years ago. What I have here is a correct answer, mugging and or hurting and hitting.
Aha! Good. Very good, Mary. Two on the first number is not bad. All right, Linda.
Are you ready for what the football coach said?
No.
Sure, babe.
Now, you're ready.
Oh, yes, I'm
we
sure
went to the
is.
Game together. You remember football?
Right. Yeah, I thought football was over.
Hey, listen, I got to tell you about this. A friend of his took us to the game, to the Super Bowl game, in a 1961 Rolls Royce that was built for the Queen of the Netherlands.
And it's this an guy antique is the Queen of the Netherlands. Yes.
I mean, I have never felt so elegant in all my life, and it was just a wonderful experience. And the game was good, too.
Yeah, the game was good.
Anyway, the football coach said, that new player is so bad.
Now, is this the Queen of the Netherlands? Or
no, no,
York,
no.
Did we
no,
say
no, 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 wait, no, no, I'm reading about, I'm reading the football, about the football coach who said,
that
new player is so bad, instead of sending him out for a pass, I sent him out for a blank.
So do I.
Linda, the football coach said, your card is not all the way in the slot there, Robert.
He hasn't even written an answer.
I wasn't supposed to write. I thought I was out of this one.
Apparently, that's the case.
You may read now.
This man wrote an article for the Chicago Tribune.
He can't write a word.
You really didn't have to put the article in a slot. You could hear it.
Football coach said, that new player is so bad, instead of sending him out for a pass, I sent him out for a...
A burger? Hamburger?
A hamburger. All right?
That's good.
What's wrong with that answer?
There's nothing wrong with that answer, audience.
So why are you shrugging?
Listen, now, wait a minute. I know why. You watch his program at home, don't you? And you hear the audience's boo, so you think you have to come here and boo. Now, it's not necessarily true.
That's right.
Now, just to get it out of your system, let's all boo at one time and then get it to and stop. All right. All ready? All right. Now, that is the last boo we're going to hear today. Now, if we get a really rotten answer, I will call upon you to boo. But no spontaneous volunteer boos, if you please. All right.
Well, I said, I didn't hear A, so I said broads, make it singular, broad.
So not for a broad.
Girl, female, woman, anything.
He's only kidding, Gloria Steinem.
There's been something to offend everyone on this show, and it's only Monday.
All right.
Sandwich.
There's a good answer. Send him out for a sandwich.
Moving right along.
Yes, please
as
do.
As I feel we must. Yeah. Soda is what I said. Send him out for soda.
Soda. All right, soda sandwich. She said hamburger. Pretty good answer. What have you got there, Connie?
Send him out for a lesson.
A lesson.
Oh, I like that.
A lot of big lessons. That's cute. Bill?
Send him out for coffee.
Coffee? He became the team gopher.
Thank you for going through that boo thing, because they really, I could feel they really want to go. I could see their mouths forming. Bless
you. Yes?
Oh, I should have had a medal. 6 years of this. First of all, if a hamburger isn't a sandwich, what is, I ask you?
Yeah.
We never match specifics and generals on this show. We just can't do it. It's impossible.
Is that a rule?
Then everything would be a match.
Oh. Send him out for Chinese.
Send him out for Chinese. Chinese food. So it's 2-0 in the end of round one. And we'll go to round two in a moment or so. Right now, we've got this for you, if you please. Right, now we're ready to go to round two. And Mary, since you're ahead, you go first.
B.
All right. What are you doing?
He's going through his pockets on my body, and we're having a very good time. So you just ask your questions.
Well, you don't play this round because you matched in the previous round.
That's why he's going through his pockets on my body. I told you, just ask the question.
Okay.
So we can play it, too. Let's play together.
Ugly Edna.
Well, she's beautiful. I've never seen her.
She's very beautiful. You've never worked the show with her before.
No.
Oh, she's good.
Oh, yes,
good,
we did a Pontiac.
Right?
We did a thing. Oh, I can't mention things. She's wearing my hair.
We did a thing for a car.
She's wearing your hair? Right. Ugly Edna is really ugly.
They've done that before.
Yes. Not only does she have bags under her eyes, she has bags under her blanks. don't
come out the way I had it.
You don't want us to say anything about bags under eyes?
Well, I'm not the one to talk about bags under eyes, but I mean just to make fun of people because they're
You don't have bags under your eyes. You just have protuberant eyeballs.
Under my eyes. I have an entire set. I'm not going to say that.
Mary Beagle. Wait. Ugly Ed is really ugly. Not only does she have bags under her eyes, she has bags under her blanks.
Her blisms. Yeah!
Well, I do declare.
Oh, honey, that's in bad taste. Get over here.
Bags under her boobs?
I don't understand that. I've never seen that.
You don't get out much, do you?
No, I don't.
Yes.
What have you got there?
It's never heard him so far. I said she has bags under her bag.
Bags under her bag.
I hate to be second. I said the same thing. Bags
under
her bag.
Bags under her bag. Yes. And what did you say?
This is the worst possible situation in the world. Bags under her buns.
Oh. Come on.
Which are the buns and which are the...
These are the buns.
These are the buns and those are the boobs.
Well, then that was wrong.
Brother, a bun
that
was man wrong, yeah. Boob man.
Oh. And bags under the bags. Who doesn't know his bosoms from his...
I don't know my buns from my bags. Bags from I love a bag bun of buns, please.
All right. All right. Now, we've got one for you, Linda, which reads as follows. Little Rodney Rotten is really rotten. I'll tell you, he got hold of some of that super glue, and now his dog has had the same blank in his mouth for a week. You understand that you play this round?
I've got to put...
That's the way it goes.
Somebody's
right. Got
to give him a wake-up pill.
Yeah. Little Rodney Rotten is really rotten. He got a hold of some of that super glue, and now his dog has had the same blank in his mouth for a week.
Bone.
He said bone.
She
said bone. What did you say?
Well, I was going to say mailman, but I said bone. I said
mailman bone would be good because that's their occupational hazard. Yes. Need one more to tie and two to win. What do we got?
Odd that the woman would say bone, isn't it? That's what I said.
That's bone. Odd. That wins the game. All right, Linda, congratulations. What do you have? I'm a little blue dot. Now, Mary, that's game number one, and you'll be back later for game number two, all right? Now, let's see how much money you're going to win here with the big super ad. Let's swing it around there and get her going. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, Linda. We said write down your best answer to this. Ankle blank. $500 for you if you match the answer they wrote down most often. We give you $250 for matching the second most popular answer. And then we give you $100 if you match the third most popular answer. Three of the six dingbats will assist you by suggesting answers.
Marcia.
Ankle bracelet.
Yeah! Ankle bracelet.
Ankle length.
Ankle length.
Heart.
Oh, John.
If you're picking on me, ankle sprain. Yeah.
Sprain.
Ankle sprain.
He meant straps. He said strain, no, but he meant straps.
Ankle, right. I didn't. I meant back sprain. Blue down. Sprain your ankle? It's an ankle sprain.
Ankle length, ankle sprain, and ankle bracelet are the three they've given you. Now you can choose one of those or think up one of your own.
Ankle bracelet.
You want ankle bracelet? All right, that was Marcia's answer. Let's see if there's an ankle bracelet up there. May we see the first one, please?
Ankle sprain.
Ankle sprain.
Doesn't look so dumb all of a sudden, does it?
No. Not as dumb as I thought it was. Let's see the next one, please.
What did she say?
Ankle bone.
Ankle you know, bone's attached to the... Ankle
connected
bone
to the...
Never mind, the ankle yeah strap. Yeah.
All right, last chance for ankle bracelet. Here we go with a big $500 number. Go! Linda, you've got $500, which is yours there. That means the least you can play for is $5,000. However, you might be able to play for more than that, and we'll find out what happens in that regard right after we find out about this. The $500, that means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But we want to step up there, spin the star wheel, see if she can double it to $10,000. Have a go at it, and good luck to you. Here we go. Come to you, Connie.
Connie Stevens, yay!
Connie it is. All right.
Still you can do here. It, Blondie.
Good luck to you. Around this way. There we go. Ready? Here it is. Male blank. That's M-A-I-L blank. Male blank.
Male blank?
Male blank. Yep. Put it in the slot if you're ready, Connie. All right. Now, if you give us the answer that she has on the card, we give you $5,000.
Mailbox.
Mailbox.
She went just the opposite.
Would you say that? You'd say mailbox. Mailman? Well, make up your mind.
Mail order.
Connie, what do you got there?
A lot of choices.
I'm sorry, sweetheart.
Mailman. Mailman and mailbox were the two choices there, and they did not get together on them. Now, Linda, you're going to be at get your other player back here again, Mary Bingham.
Well, make up your mind.
And all right, I will make up. Who is it? Oh, there's Mary Bingham. Yeah, I remember her. You want to get back on the merry-go-round? And we'll start game number two here, if I can get my mouth together. And, Mary, if you're all set, you can have A, B, or C.
B.
B, all right. Ready?
Sure.
I'm not.
You're not alone.
Rick said, my wife is the world's worst driver.
Oh. How worse
oh,
is she?
Oh, boy. Today she wanted to know what the correct hand signal was for backing over a blank. Is that a good one? That's a good one.
Yeah, I like it.
He never studied Palmer method penmanship, did he?
I was sorely tempted to bring a dictionary with me today so I wouldn't be humiliated on national television.
Why, you don't...
Too late, Martin.
I'm so dumb I forgot. I meant to bring a dictionary.
You're a little nervous about your spelling?
No, I'm not nervous about it. I can't do it. I know I am not nervous.
Don't worry about it, because people of your generation never learned how to spell.
Don't say that. The
school system failed you. They really did. My generation knows how to spell.
I knew there was a reason I didn't like those people.
Rick said, my wife is the world's worst driver. Today she wanted to know what the correct hand signal was for backing over a blank.
Bicycle.
A bicycle. Correct hand signal for backing over a bicycle. I don't think anyone over here would say anything like that.
It's a little logical for this group.
Yes, it is.
I thought it was cliff at first for backing over a cliff. But I said a person.
A person. All right.
That's how worse she was.
Cliff Person. You remember him. Yes?
I said an accident victim struck when she was going forward.
Uh-huh. Got them both ways.
I think I actually spelled this right. I said pedestrian.
Pedestrian.
Backing over a pedestrian. I'm correct. Not going to be graded on this, Miss Summers. I got graded by a school system that failed me.
That's right. They failed me.
And when I say they failed me, I mean they failed me.
I mean they failed me.
All right, Connie. Today, you want to know what the correct hand signal was for backing over a...
These are getting harder. I stayed up too late. Hydrant.
Hydrant. What were you up late for last night?
It's me.
Never mind.
Oh, I beg your pardon. Yeah. Bill?
I was going to say an old, crippled, blind nun. I said policeman, so.
A policeman! What is the correct hand signal? Anybody know when you're going to... well, never mind.
We can't do that on the air.
No.
Oh, we can't do that on the air.
Can't show it on the air.
You need not go like that.
Oh, all right. Marcia, darling.
Jean.
Oh, Marcia.
Oh, Jean.
Marcia.
I think you're so adequate. Mailman.
Mailman.
That was my last. I know, it was another question.
All right.
You hang around for your
first round question. Now, this for you, if you please. Oh, listen, you were all more than adequate.
Not much.
No, I think you were just splendid, but you'll get better.
Well, honestly.
What's wrong?
Oh, nothing.
Got an itch there?
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Does this feel good?
We have 10 more minutes to kill, so this is going to be boring.
10 seconds?
This is the most exciting thing that's happened to me so far in the 80s.
I'm Gene Rayburn. Hope you'll join us next time for the Match Game. Thank you, one and all. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are Oleg Cassini's World, a world of uncompromising elegance and style expressed in these, the signature fragrances of Oleg Cassini brought to you by Jovan. And a selection of Castle & Cook products including delicious Dole bananas, fresh and canned pineapple, fresh mushrooms, and bumblebee seafoods. And a paper-made family of products including freezer wrap to protect the foods you freeze, baking cups, coffee filters, and paper-made plastic cups for all occasions. And like Mads the manicurist says, try Maya Palmolive dishwashing liquid. Palmolive softens hands while you do dishes and it makes loads of thick, long-lasting suds. And delicious pork products. Roasts and ribs, steaks and chops, tender, love and fair from the national pork producers. And potato toppers. Exciting flavor, color, and texture for baked, mashed, and boiled potatoes. Just sprinkle and serve in your grocer's produce section. Potato toppers. And off with the most effective mosquito repellent ingredient that money can buy. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program is edited for Buck.